Good evening and welcome for Lutheran Church of Honolulu's Monday-Thursday service. Like many of you, I grieve that you are not able to be here, that we are not able to be together in this space. Our usual practice on Monday-Thursday is the rite of washing one another's feet and also of receiving communion together. Because of our diaspora, we're unable to do that tonight, and so tonight's service will focus around peace and tranquility, around hearing the word and remembering to whom we belong. Let's begin the order of service with our welcome. We gather this night, a church apart.
Yet God draws us to one another this night.
We gather this night in the midst of uncertainty and fear.
Yet we know God.
We gather this night in homes, apartments, by ourselves, and with family.
Yet God makes us church, one body in Christ.
We gather knowing that not everyone can be present.
Yet we know that God's love is sufficient for all.
Let's join together in singing "Stay With Me." This is the struggle to which we were called at baptism. Within the community of the church, God never wearies of forgiving sin and giving peace of reconciliation. On this night, let us confess our sin against God and our neighbor and enter into the celebration of the three great days, reconciled with God and one another. Let us keep the silence. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may be light in your will Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's take a moment to share that peace with one another. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We gather in these 3 days to celebrate the great mystery of our faith.
Dying, you destroyed our death.
Rising,
you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Holy God, source of all love, on the night of his betrayal, Jesus gave us a new commandment, to love one another as he loves us. Write this commandment on our hearts, and give us the will to serve others as he was the servant of all, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us hear God's word.
A reading from Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year old male, and may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roasted over the fire with its head, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning, you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout our generations, you shall observe it. Perpetual ordinance. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with a towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not now know what I am doing, but later you will understand." And Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not only my feet, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, and is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you as an example that you should also do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. Now the Son of Man is glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am only with you a little longer. You will look for me. And as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You should also love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We'll go on with the sermon for a few moments, and then we'll move to where charity and love prevail. Grace to you and peace from God who creates and redeems and sustains all things. Amen. As I said at the beginning of our service, it's difficult to not have all of you here. We are so accustomed to being gathered in this place, and for, at least in our congregation, the kids who come year after year to have their feet washed, and the same people who refuse every year to have their feet washed refuse again. There is something intimate and powerful, something a little scary, about exposing ourselves to one another in quite that way. And yet, that night, Jesus does exactly that. The master, the one who is in control, the one they all look up to, the one who had done miracle after miracle, who had healed the sick, helped the blind see, taken away leprosy, who had driven the money changers out of the temple, now wraps a towel around his waist and kneels at the feet of his disciples and becomes a servant. It's an extraordinary moment. And it's an extraordinary moment that precedes something that will come very shortly. Jesus' own death on the cross. Because the powerful thing for Maundy Thursday for me is that it becomes crystal clear in this Gospel of John. We suddenly can see what love looks like from God's perspective. God looks at love in this way. This is what love looks like for God. God pours God's self out, wraps a towel around God's waist, and kneels at our feet, doing the most menial task, the one reserved for the lowest servant, the lowest slave. God sanctifies us in the washing of feet. God sanctifies us in humility. God sanctifies our very life out of death. This is what love looks like. Each day, the numbers of people who are dying here in the United States and around the world mounts higher and higher. Somehow it is a powerful thing to be reminded that God is in the midst of it. That in the midst of all of our fear and our anxiety, God continues to wrap that towel around God's waist and kneel before us, to remind us what love looks like. Do not lose hope, as the disciples will momentarily after they've been to the garden. Do not lose hope, as it is so easy to do in these difficult days. Remember what love looks like. Looks like this. God's love in Jesus Christ are called to love one another. to be servants to each other as Jesus became our servant. Our commitment to this loving service is signified in prayer and service to one another, especially to those most in need. We look forward to a time when we will once again wash one another's feet as a tangible sign of God's love. Let us pray together. Turning our hearts to God, who is gracious and merciful, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God of love, unite your church in its commitment to humble service. Make us your faithful disciples. Speak words of truth and grace through us. Encourage us in self-giving acts of kindness. Let us love one another as you have loved us. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of love, tend to flocks, fields, and vineyards. Bring favorable weather for crops to grow. Guide the hands of those who cultivate, farm, and garden. Let the earth flourish so that all may eat and be satisfied. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of love, you give us a new commandment, to have love for one another. We give thanks for organizations that respond to disasters, for agencies that offer relief and humanitarian aid to populations in need. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of love, give ear to all who call on you for any need of body or spirit, especially Arnold, Barbara, Billy, Carol, Charlotte, Colleen, Eduardo, George, Greg, Kathy, Kiaki, Kendra, Patricia, Rezzy, Shirley, Vonia, and those we name in our hearts. Provide for those who do not have enough to eat, those who are unemployed or underemployed, those who are sick from the virus which is plaguing our world, and those who rely on the generosity of others. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of love, you invite us to your table of mercy. Heal all divisions between members of this assembly. Extend the hospitality of this table beyond those walls, that your love and welcome may be known to all. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For what else do the people of God pray? We give you thanks, O God, for all who are putting their own lives at risk during this COVID-19 pandemic, for doctors and nurses, for bus drivers and grocery store workers, for everyone who is so necessary to keep our society in some state of normalcy. We give you thanks for their sacrifice, for their risk. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
According to your steadfast love, O God, hear these and all our prayers as we commend them to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
It is now time for the offering. You are invited to make your offering either by mailing it to LCH, or you may also go to our website and do a donation online. We invite the choir to have our offertory motet, Ubi Caritas.
I did that.
Okay.
Let us pray. God of glory, receive these gifts and the offerings of our lives. As Jesus was lifted up from the earth, draw us to your heart in the midst of this world, that all creation may be brought from bondage to freedom, from darkness to light, from death to life. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Our service continues tomorrow evening with the online Good Friday liturgy. It's tomorrow evening at 7:30 p.m.